warm welcome to all my lovely children. Once again, welcome back to your English class. Children, in the last class, we talked about sentences and subject predicate. So, we learned that the subject is the part of the sentence that tells us who or what the sentence is about. Also, the predicate is the remaining part of the sentence which tells us what the subject is or what the subject does. Okay? Today we are going to learn about compound subjects and compound predicates. Children, compound subjects and compound predicates add a lot of variety and depth to our reading, our writing, as well as speaking. So let's learn about compound subjects and compound predicates. So children, let's see what a compound subject in a sentence is. So when a sentence has more than one subject, okay, so it is called a compound subject. It could be either a noun or a pronoun. So subject in a sentence is joined by another subject through conjunctions like, you know what are conjunctions? Joining words are conjunctions. Conjunctions like and, or, nor. It becomes a compound subject. Okay, when a sentence has more than one subject in it, either a noun or a pronoun, it becomes a compound subject. Okay, for example, Tom and Jerry are playing hide and seek. Okay, so let's identify the subject here. So, Tom, Jerry, there are two subjects in this sentence. Okay, so that means it is a compound subject. And we can clearly see that both the subjects are joined by the conjunction and. Okay, you want to see another example? Bhopal and Indore are smart cities. Okay, so what are the subject here? Bhopal is first subject and Indore is the second subject. Both are connected with the conjunction and. So this sentence has a compound subject. Is it clear? Since we have learned about compound subjects, now let's see what compound predicates are. Compound predicate is when a sentence has more than one predicate in it. Okay? When a sentence has more than one predicate in it, it is called a compound predicate. Okay? So, predicate means the verb, the rest of the sentence other than the subject. Let me show you some examples. So, the first example is Rhea is talking and eating. Okay? So what is the predicate here? Is talking and eating. Can you see there are two predicates? two verbs over here, talking and eating. So this sentence has a compound predicate. All right. Let's see the second example. Dolphins are cute and intelligent. Okay. So dolphins, it is the subject here. And what is the predicate? Cute and intelligent. Do you see these two words here? So that means it is a compound predicate. Dear children, sometimes a sentence can have both compound subjects as well as compound predicates in it. Let's see that example. Ria and Karan like chess and football. So see this sentence, Ria and Karan. Here we have two subjects connected with the conjunction and. So this is a compound subject. Okay. Same way, here we can see two words. So these are compound predicate. Isn't it interesting? Yes, it is interesting. We will have a practice of this in the next slide. Alright?
Okay, dear children, let's have a recap of today's topic learned. So today's topic was compound subject and compound predicate. A compound subject is a simple subject made up of more than one noun or pronoun. The subjects are joined by conjunctions and, or. For example, meat and fish provide protein for the body. Now let's move on to the compound predicate. A compound predicate is more than one verb relating to the same subject. They are usually joined by conjunctions such as but, and, or. For example, the kids climbed and played on the jungle gym. Children, now it's time for some practice, some tasks. Okay, now I'm giving you some sentences. You have to form compound subjects and compound predicates with them. We will meet again in the next video. Till then, take care of yourselves.